It's Nitro 99 again, doing a review on the new LEGO Marvel Super Heroes, Wolverine's Chopper Showdown, 201 pieces, 28 stars, 3 brand new minifigures, and it's Marvel X-Men, and the other set I reviewed is Marvel Avengers, which that was yesterday, so check out that video if you haven't already, because it's a good new set. But this set is the other $20 set. It's one probably most of you will be getting, and is it a worthy purchase? I would say right off the bat, yes. However, you know, it has some problems. First off, first minifigure is Wolverine. Duh. He's only X-Men available at the moment. And of course, they made him first because he's the most iconic and popular. He looks pretty good. Torso is very nice. Leg printing. Face printing is very good as well. He has a double-sided head. And, you know, of course, you can see his mouth on back of his head every time. But, you know, it's a minor problem. And also his new claw piece, which, just like in the Prince of Persia sets, it's just put into the hand like that. And you get an extra one, so you have three of these. At least I got an extra one. Some of you may not be so lucky. He also has his motorcycle, which is just a gray motorcycle. Looks pretty good. Next is Deadpool. He's a mercenary, anti-hero kind of guy. He has a gun and two swords. The swords are actually on the helicopter in a minute because LEGO always likes to put their weapons on the, you know, on the side of vehicles for some stupid reason. Because, you know, that's how it's really easy for him to get them from there. But, yeah, he looks very cool. I'm sure this is a very popular character. I don't know much about X-Men, unfortunately. The only Marvel superhero I know kind of a lot about is Spider-Man. But Deadpool, reading up on him, he seems like a pretty cool guy. And he's a very cool figure. He also has, you know, the sword holster from Prince of Persia. It's not in a new color or anything. And he has back printing that looks pretty stellar. Look at that belt. Nice belt. Yeah, so the final figure is Magneto. And he's, you know, the main bad guy in X-Men universe. I know that much. And I'm pretty sure he controls metal, but he might be just telekinetic. But, you know, he's, you know, swooshes stuff around his mind. And he's a very cool figure. I mean, his helmet's very nicely designed, molded well, fits well. I hope, I mean, it'd be kind of nice to have this in a different color for Castle, but Castle themes, but never know. Maybe in the future. Even his back printing, though he has a cape. And the cape is purple. If you can't tell, it looks like a dark blue in the video probably, but it's purple. And he has a double-sided face. And his face is new, unlike Loki from the previous set. And also Iron Man, who apparently was an old face. This is actually a new face. And he looks very cool in it. And he's levitating on this piece of metal. So, yeah, those figures are definitely must-buys. That their figures alone are worth bidding the set. And the only problem with the set is the helicopter. It just looks retarded. It's like something, you know that movie Super Babies? I've never watched that, but I know, just from reading the title, I know it's going to be stupid. So, it's something they would drive, like a baby helicopter, something Duplo would make. I think it looks dumb. I'm sure someone is going to comment that, I like this helicopter, it looks cool. Well, yeah, that's good for you. But I think it looks dumb. However, it does have 201 pieces, so, I mean, it just breaks the, you know, mold for a good value for money. And of course, 3 new figures makes this set a winning deal. And there's not much to really show about this helicopter. I mean, it doesn't have any play feature, it just opens up. Has those flickfire missiles. And the missiles are in metallic. Yes, I'm flicking the flickfire missiles off. Because I don't like them. But they are in metallic, so I thought that was interesting that they do that. And of course, the two black swords for Deadpool are there. And then there's big open space for Magneto, I guess. Just kind of hits in there. That's how he rolls. And back here, there's tiny propellers and yeah. So yeah, that's looks pretty lame. But let's get onto the comic or manual. There's a little comic. It's worth showing. Manual doesn't have anything of note. The comic is nice. Of course, in the back, you know, superheroes. The Spider-Man set, I looked up on this. I saw it on forum, but it's actually based off a new animated series, so I'll have to look into that. And hopefully there's more sets, because I like Spider-Man the most out of all the Marvel superheroes. More of a DC kind of guy. And the figures. Ultimate Spider-Man. So I just googled that, but I didn't pay attention. And here's the comic. X-Men. Deadpool is approaching looks like the Endor barricade from Star Wars. And immediately, Wolverine just gets pissed off and attacks him, and these are fighting. But then he somehow gets knocked out. And, he's hiding behind a tree because he can teleport somehow. And he's like, whoa, I got a motorcycle. He's going to use that. So he goes, vroom, in the helicopter, and then he jumps somehow. I don't know how he's doing all these things. And, he used Fus Ro Dah. Yeah, that's right. Fus Ro Dah. And blows that thing up. And Magneto escapes. And then they're kind of fighting in the air. Except Deadpool gets pwned. And then Magneto just kind of stops them somehow. And that's it. That was a very exciting comic. But I think this set was actually from the movie. The Wolverine movie. I haven't seen it because the only superhero movies I've watched, I actually like, is the Batman ones because they're well written. Most superhero movies, I think, are just kind of, forced. The whole thing is just forced. It's more action than intellectual discussions and stuff like that. But yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this review. It's a good set overall. I recommend buying it for the pieces and the figures, unless you just don't like the figures and you don't like this, I guess you could bricklink them, but you're going to spend about $20 to get the figures anyway. And of course, check out my other review on that, which was yesterday, and hopefully soon my other sets will be shipping. There's two other ones, I'll let you guess which ones those are, and I'll be reviewing those. So, hope you enjoyed this. See you later. Bye.